The latest changes to mask rules have been labelled confusing and contradictory. National Cabinet agreed to scrap the requirement to wear face masks on planes, but Victorian rules still mandate them on public transport. Shubhar Krishnan reports.
They're soon to be abolished on planes, but masks will still be required on public transport in Victoria.
Yeah, I think it's confusing. I just try to follow the rules.
COVID restrictions across the country will be relaxed in 8 days' time, but Victorians say the changes are contradictory and confusing.
Every time I get on a tram or a train, there's an announcement saying it's still mandatory, but only maybe half the people are actually wearing them.
I actually don't know what the rule is, to be honest, so I think a lot of people don't as well.
I think common sense should prevail.
Isolation rules will also ease. People who've tested positive for COVID will only be required to isolate for 5 days instead of seven.
I'm quite comfortable with that. I've had COVID. I think after the fifth day, I probably would have been ready to come back.
Brent Barber owns a hairdressing salon on Chapel Street. Like many businesses, he's struggled with staffing shortages.
Any days that the guys can be in salon is definitely going to be a help to us for sure.
But epidemiologist Nancy Baxter warns infections will rise.
This will make it less safe to be at work, so you're more likely to be exposed to people with COVID.
While the state government welcomes the new national rules, it still won't budge on state restrictions, today confirming it has no plans to axe mandatory mask wearing on public transport.
Masks are a very simple and effective way to reduce the spread of the virus. We've still got COVID in our community.
The new COVID-19 rule changes come into effect next Friday.
Shubhar Krishnan has some breaking news. Shubhar, the working from home recommendations have been dropped.
That's right, Pete. The Health Minister, Mary-Ann Thomas, has just released a statement encouraging Victorians to return to the office safely. The working from home recommendations have been in place for some time and were kept in place during the peak periods of COVID in July and August, when their health system was also under significant pressure during winter months. Now, the Health Department has advised that this pressure and transmission risk has reduced. We know business groups have been pushing for this to happen for some time. Now the government is acting, just minutes ago announcing it'll lift its working from home recommendation. Pete?
Okay, thank you, Shubhar Krishnan.